Going to learn a new chapter called Retirement of a Partner. We are going to learn procedure for retirement of a partner under Indian Partnership Act 1932. A partner can leave the firm at any time but with the consent of all the partners under section 32 subsection 1 of Indian Partnership Act 1932. If any partner leaves the firm, what role he is entitled? He entitled, look at the board, a returning partner entitled to capital to his credit. So we have to pay his capital. Then his share of reserves. We have to pay his share of reserve. The third one is his share of profit. If he retires on the period ending. That is, if he retired on balance sheet date, we'll give his share of profit fully. If he retired during the year, we will not give his share of profit, we will give a proportionate share of profit. Yes, if he retired during the year, proportionate share of profit or loss will be given to the retiring partner. Then his share of goodwill, the retiring partner share of goodwill to be adjusted with his capital. Then the revaluation, his share of revaluation profit or loss given to the retiring partner. Then finally, the total interest payable to the retiring partner, that we called final settlement. So if any partner leaves the firm, he is entitled to his capital, his share of reserve, his share of profit or loss, his share of goodwill to be adjusted, and his share of revaluation profit or loss. Yes, students, today we are going to learn about the transfer of undistributed profit, reserves and losses. Look at the problem. This is a very good example. Today we are going to learn transfer of undistributed profit, reserves and losses. What is undistributed profit? Last year profit, previous year profit not yet distributed to the partner called undistributed profit. That what do you mean by reserve? Reserve is an accumulated profit. The profit, what is the reserve? Reserve is a reserve is an amount set aside from the profit of the business to adjust unforeseen losses, that we called undistributed profit. Losses we know. Now I am going to give you one very good example for transfer of reserve and profit and loss account. Look at the board. A, B and C are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 5:3:2. Their balance sheet as at 31st December 2018 is given. Liability side, general reserve is given. General reserve always given in the liability side, it shows always credit balance. It shows always credit balance. Always it shows credit balance. Okay, who is retiring? B decided to retire from the firm on 1st January 2019. Now, we will transfer this reserve to all the partner, including the retiring partner. The entry is general reserve account it are. General reserve or reserve fund account it are to old partner, or we can say all the partners. So ABC capital account in old ratio. So the general reserve transferred to old partner capital account in old ratio. In old ratio. Narration, general reserve transfer to A, B and C capital account in old ratio. So general reserve always appeared in the liability side. It shows credit balance. It may be general reserve or reserve fund. Okay. Then come to workman compensation fund or a contingency reserve, or we can say investment fluctuation fund. Investment fluctuation fund, investment fluctuation fund. General reserve is a general reserve is not a specific reserve, but investment fluctuation fund, workman compensation fund, contingency reserve, these are all called specific reserve. This we called a revenue reserve. These reserves, investment fluctuation fund, workman compensation fund, contingency reserve, these should be transferred to the old partner capital account in old ratio. For this, the entry is the specific reserve account data to old partner capital account. Sometimes the specific reserve may have a liability. For example, workman compensation fund given in the balance sheet 10,000. Adjustment says workman compensation payable. Workman compensation payable rupees 2,000. If this adjustment is not given, the entire workman compensation fund should be transferred to A capital, B capital, C capital in 5:3:2. Here, the fund is 10,000. The liability at the time of retirement is 2,000. Now, the difference 8,000 rupees should be transferred to A capital, B capital, C capital. Then in new balance sheet, 2,000 will appear. Yes. Likewise, we have to treat for investment fluctuation fund and contingency reserve. Then we'll move to the profit and loss account. Profit and loss account, sometime it may appear in the liability side. Profit and loss account, sometime it may appear in the liability side. Always it shows credit balance. If it appeared in the liability side, it shows credit balance, which is also known as undistributed, undistributed profit. For this entry is profit and loss account data to A capital, to B capital, to C capital. A capital, B capital and C capital. So the profit and loss account should be transferred to old partner capital account in old ratio. The narration is profit and loss account transferred to A, B and C capital account. Here we can say the general reserve and profit and loss account can be transferred to, should be transferred to old partner, or we can say all the partner. So profit and loss account, if it appeared in the liability side, the entry is profit and loss account to A capital, B capital, C capital. Always the profit and loss account, if it appeared in the liability side, it shows credit balance, which is also called undistributed profit. We learned the journal for profit and loss account in the liability side. Now, sometime the profit and loss account appeared in the asset side. Profit and loss account appeared in the asset side. It shows debit balance. It shows debit balance, which is also called undistributed, which is also called undistributed losses. Undistributed losses. The entry is, we have to reverse this entry. Entry is capitals accounted are, capital accounted are to profit and loss account. Capital accounted are to profit and loss account. It should be divided in old ratio. Narration is profit and loss account data, profit and loss account transferred to A, B and C capital account. Students, once again, general reserve always appeared in the liability side. It shows credit balance. The entry is general reserve account data to old partner, all partner capital account. Profit and loss account, we should be very careful. If it appeared in liability side, the entry is profit and loss account data to old partner capital account, namely A, B, C. In old ratio, we should divide. Sometime the profit and loss account appeared in the asset side. The entry is capital account should be debited. All partner capital account should be debited. Profit and loss account should be credited. When we deal with this specific reserve, this reserve they created for the particular purpose. When we transfer these three reserves, we should be very careful. If there is no adjustment, we can transfer this amount entirely to the partner's capital account. If there is any adjustment, we should leave that liability. The remaining amount should be transferred to the partner capital account. Students, let me solve some problem in relation to the reserves and the profit and loss account. Let me learn three problem in relation to transfer of general reserve and profit and loss account. Look at the board. Sum number one, Vivin, Hari and Joy are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2:1. On 31st December 2017, Hari retired. So Hari is retiring. On date of retirement, the book showed, book means balance sheet. Balance sheet showed a general reserve of 60,000. Past journal entry. I said earlier, the general reserve always appeared in the liability side. It shows credit balance. So when general reserve is given, blindly we can record general reserve account data to old partner capital account. The entry is general reserve account data. General reserve account data to old partner capital account, or we can say all partners. So Vivin capital account data to Hari capital account data to Joy Capital account. The value 60,000, it should be divided in old ratio. It should be divided in old ratio. The old ratio is 3:2:1. So 3/6, 2/6 and 1/6. So 60,000 into 3/6. 60,000 into 2/6. 60,000 into 1/6. So now we'll get 30,000, 20,000 and 10,000. So narration is general reserve transferred to Vivin, Ari and Joy Capital in old ratio. So sum number one is over. Sum number one is over. Then sum number two. Mary, Meena and Mariam are partners sharing profits and the losses equally. So equally there are three partners. 1:1:1. If there are two partners, 1:1. Yes. On 1st January 2019, Mary retired. On that date, their balance sheet shows accumulated loss. I said, if it is a loss, it appeared in the asset side. The profit and loss account appeared in the asset side. Now the entry is capital should be debited. So Mariam, Mary capital account it are. Mary capital account it are. Meena capital account it are. Mariam capital account it are. To profit and loss account. So undistributed loss means accumulated loss means the profit and loss account appeared in the asset side. That is a loss. Okay. It shows debit balance. So value of the transaction 75,000. They shared equally. Equally means 1:1:1. So 25,000, 25,000, 25,000. So 75,000 into 1/3. 75,000 into 1/3, 75,000 into 1/3. Narration, profit and loss account transfer to Mary, Meena and Mariam Capital. Students, let me solve the third problem. Sum number 3. Prince, Dev, Sasi are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2:1. Their balance sheet as on 31st March 2019 as follows. Liability assets. Liability side capital, profit loss account, general reserve, workman compensation fund, creditor are given. Asset side building, plant, furniture, stock, debt or bank are given. Then adjustment, Dev decided to retire from the firm. So Dev is retiring from the firm. Give journal entry for accumulated profit and profit and loss account. Yes, they are asking journal entry for transfer of reserve and profit and loss account. So we have to record journal for profit and loss account, general reserve and workman compensation fund. Students, here we can record compound entry for these three items, but we should not record compound entry for these three items because when we record compound entry, we may face some difficulty when we post these items to the capital account. So record always that single entry. Yes, look at the problem. Profit and loss account given in the liability side. So the entry is profit and loss account at R to Prince Capital to Dev Capital to Sasi Capital. The profit and loss account value 6,000. It should be divided in the old ratio 3:2:1. 3:2:1. So the value of transaction is 6,000. The total share 6. So one time. So 3,000 goes to Prince, 2,000 goes to Dev, 1,000 goes to Sasi. Narration is profit and loss account transferred to Prince, Dev and Sasi Capital in old ratio. Then general reserve appeared in the liability side. So we have to record general reserve account at R to Prince Capital to Dev Capital to Sasi Capital. We should divide in old ratio 3:2:1. Total shares are 6. The total value of general reserve is 12,000. So 12,000 divided by 6. So 12,000 divided by 6 2 times. So 6,000 goes to Prince, 4,000 goes to Dev, 2,000 goes to Sasi. Narration is general reserve transfer to Prince, Dev and Sasi Capital account. Yes, last one. Workman compensation fund is a specific reserve. When specific reserve is given, we should look at the adjustment. Here, no adjustment related to the workman compensation fund. We can transfer the entire workman compensation fund to the Prince, Dev and Sasi Capital. If any work workman compensation liability is given, we should leave the amount, the remaining amount should be transferred to the partner's capital account. Here no adjustment, we can transfer fully workman compensation fund account data to old partner Prince, to Dev, to Sasi Capital. Prince capital account data, Dev capital account data, Sasi capital. The value of workman compensation fund 18,000. So 18,000 divided by 6, 3 times. So ratio we should divide in 3 is to 2 is to 1. So 3 3s are 9, 3 2s are 6, 1 3s are 3. So narration, workman compensation fund transferred to Prince, Dev and Sasi Capital. Students, we completed transfer of general reserve and profit and loss account to the old partner in case of retirement of a partner. Students, in next class we will solve different problem. Till then, bye and thank you.